Parmi les énergies marines renouvelables,
among the renewable maritime energies,
on peut voir déjà qui existent depuis longtemps,
the ones that have been in existence for some time in Northern Europe countries,
donc les plus connues du grand public.
And are the most
sont les éoliennes.
Well known
alors,
are
deux types d'éoliennes, celles qui sont connues,
windmills, wind turbines. There are two types of wind turbines that are bottom-mounted towers, the foundations of which are resting on the sea bottom, and there are also floating wind turbines. Now, they have a number of things in common, although they differ through their foundations. First of all,
on constate, et ça, l'expérience des pays d'Inde,
we have observed, and this was confirmed by the experience of northern countries, the wind resource for a water wind turbine is much better at sea versus the wind inland. What do we mean by better? Well, the wind intensity, the force, and also is better, and also the altitude at which we find good quality wind is lower.
Eh bien, on
you see a graph
que,
here,
vous voyez la forme du, de
and
ces,
if
ces trois dessins
we look at the shape of the graphs, we understand that in order to find enough intensity,
à terre, que dans
inland,
une
we need to climb
désert,
much higher than in the middle of a desert or at sea, because inland there are obstacles, buildings, mountains, hills that will influence the quality of the wind resource.
Ça, on a malheureusement en mer, on a à payer
however,
sous une autre forme. C'est que l'environnement est bien
at
plus sévère.
Sea, the environment alors, is much more severe and stressful. We see here, for instance, on the right-hand side, that the windmill will suffer from the wind force.
But
that makes sense, because that's exactly what we're trying to achieve. We want a maximum of wind to push the blades of the wind turbine. However, the windmill will also suffer from cresting waves, or swell, or a number of other such like disadvantages. And also, the environment may be very stressful for other reasons. Maritime air has a much higher hygrometry level than inland air, and also, it is saline air, and the presence of moisture and salt is quite detrimental for the electrical equipment on the windmill. It is therefore necessary to protect the windmills much better than when the windmill is installed inland. Maintenance and installation conditions are also quite different versus inland installed windmills. It is necessary to have access to the windmill, and it is not always easy to gain access to the windmill when the sea is rough and when ships or boats cannot navigate. Because of all these constraints, the machines that are being installed offshore are slightly different in design from the inland turbines. The two main family of turbines are
de la rotation de,
well, the turbines are the machines that produce electricity following a blade rotation, and either the turbines will use a gearbox or they will be direct drive turbine equipment. Turbines with the gearboxes rotate more slowly, and they have a number of specific features. What are the sizes of wind turbines? In laboratory, the last machines being designed have a span of 160 meters of diameter. Just to give you an idea of what it represents, the span of both wings of an Airbus A380 would be approximately 50 meters. So we have blades that are longer than the actual span of the Airbus A300. Rotation revolution speed is 12 to 20 revolutions per minute. This type of windmill can be either bottom mounted, and you see the difference with the Airbus span on the right-hand side. picture.
Et va s'appuyer.
In this case, the foundations rest on the bottom of the sea or are anchored in the bottom of the sea. We have a few examples here, single pile or GBS, gravity base systems, being held in place by the mere weight, or tripod towers, or driven piles, or jacket towers, which are very reminiscent of the offshore oil rigs. Now, different technologies, but they have in common the fact that the foundations go to the bottom of the sea with stiff parts. But this means that we cannot exceed a certain depth, because obviously we could go much deeper, but the price would be such that the machine would not be profitable. All these machines are inspired from the oil and gas industry, offshore oil extraction and gas extraction rigs. For bottom-mounted windmills, experts agree on the fact that the technically usable potential across the world is about 1,000 gigawatts being already installed. There is another type of wind turbine that can be found offshore, floating windmills. The technology is the same, except that the foundation, rather than being resting on the sea bottom, will float
entre la plateforme
between
et le fond,
two levels, and only the anchorage will be the anchors will be resting on the sea bottom. This technology opens up new avenues for us, because the total usable power for floating windmills is 3,500 gigawatts versus 1,000 that I mentioned earlier for bottom-mounted windmills. However, the windmills can be positioned further away from the coast. The technology is more expensive and, again, is inspired from offshore oil rigs,
des fondations flottantes,
which already have put to use the floating foundations. The risk for the floating windmills is lower because there will be less conflict of usage. It will be easier to find locations where only maritime energy use will be consistent. I would like to close my presentation
par l'introduction de l'énergie thermique des mers,
by introducing thermal maritime energy.
Ce sont des machines thermodynamiques.
This type of power plant is a thermodynamic type of power plant, using the temperature difference between surface water and bottom water. For a plant to operate, the temperature difference between surface water and bottom water should be approximately 22 degrees minimum.
Ça veut dire quoi? Eh bien, ça veut dire que
what it boils down to is that in order to achieve this kind of difference, we have to go to water around the tropical belt so that the surface water is between 23 and 30 degrees.
And
water which is 22 degrees cooler can be found at the bottom of the sea, water that can be pumped from 600 or 1,000 meters of depth. Otherwise, the closed-loop operation, Rankine-type operation, is fairly simple. There is a primary circuit. Normally, in a nuclear plant, it would be water circulating, but here it's ammonia. Ammonia will be vaporized with the our higher temperature from surface water, and then ammonia will be cooled down in a condenser to become liquid again, and the condenser uses bottom water, the temperature of which is approximately 4-5 degrees. The power that can be expected from the biggest plants would be 10 to 30 megawatts per plant, and there are a few projects being developed across the world, not so many, and I'll mention the two main ones. In France, the CNS is developing a project for Martinique Island and Réunion Island. The platform would deliver 16 megawatts, and the CNS says that this type of project could ensure Réunion Island supply of electrical power, thus making the island independent with two platforms. And we also have less active projects in Hawaii. Trials are being conducted by NELA, which is the local research laboratory for renewable energies. The technically usable potential for maritime thermal energy is 150 gigawatts, because the number of areas where this type of plant can be installed is fairly limited. However, The load factor for this type of plant is fairly interesting, and it is certainly the maritime energy production system which is most reliable and sustainable in time. The machines can run 24 hours a day. They must be preserved in the event of a typhoon or for maintenance work, but otherwise they can operate 24 hours a day. All the techniques that I have introduced have one thing in common. Wind or thermal energy, all these plants are submitted to a lot of stress from the environment, and the main sizing parameter is fatigue, i.e. the plant's capacity to endure cyclical loads for a long period of time, and that is the main item that engineers designing those machines need to focus on.